What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Suppose we are given several cards arranged in a row, and each card has an associated number of points. The points are given in an integer array, so basically we have an array of int. Then at each step we can take one card from the beginning or from the end of the array. We must take k cards exactly, the value of k will be given. Our final score is the sum of the points on the cards we have taken. So, given an array and the integer k, return the maximum score we can obtain. To better understand this problem, let's visualize it and take the array of points you see in front of you alongside k equals 3. After the first step, our score will always be 2. However, choosing the leftmost card first will maximize our total score. The ultimate strategy is to take the 3 cards on the left, giving a final score of 2 plus 7 plus 6 equals 15. In the second example, taking one card from the left and two cards from the right will maximize our total score. Now, the naive solution to approach this problem is to create two pointers, one starting at the leftmost integer and the second at the rightmost integer. Then after comparing the two stored values, we increase or decrease these pointers based on which value is the biggest and add the biggest value to the cumulative max score we want. We will keep doing this until we have our k values and the maximum is obtained, right? Wrong. You see, the issue with this approach is that it only works when the values are distinct. What do I mean by this? Take a similar array to the very first example we previously had. If we try to apply this implementation on that array, we will notice that in the first iteration, both cards are equal. So, in the implementation, we proceed by taking the left card and continue. At this point in the second iteration and the one following it, we have a problem, as now the left card is bigger than the right card, and now we must take the left card again and again. But we know that the optimal solution for this array is 3 cards from the right, and the solution this implementation will give us is the exact opposite, 3 cards from the left. And if we go ahead and flip this equals operator here, we might run into the same issue, but on the other side of the array. So how do we solve this? Some may say that we can extract the equals condition and treat it separately by checking the elements next to it, but what if they are also equal? When does it end? Do we use recursion? Small tip here, while implementing a solution, if you realize that you are extracting conditions and/or are treating corner cases separately instead of trying to solve the problem as one entity, then take a step back. Forget about your previous approach and try to think about the problem from a new angle. And the new perspective that I personally considered after running into this issue is maximum and minimum subarrays. What do I mean by this? You see, while trying to extract the highest numbers from both ends of the array, what we are really trying to do is maximize the subarray you see in front of you in blue. And maximizing this subarray means that we are consequently trying to minimize the remaining elements of the given array or the subarray in green. Now, minimizing subarrays is a classic problem. Suppose k equals 3 and the array has 7 elements. This means that the subarray we are trying to minimize has a size of 4. And all the possible subarrays of size 4 that can be formed out of this array are the ones you see in front of you. The minimum between these arrays is the first one, which is the one we expected. Now, if we manage to calculate the sum of its elements and then subtract this minimum sum from the total sum of all the elements inside the array, we will obtain the sum of the remaining element or the sum of the maximum subarray of size k we are looking for. Implementing this is very straightforward. As I mentioned, the subarray to maximize has a window size of total length of the array minus k. Now, for every possible window, we will calculate the local sum of the elements inside this window and keep track of the minimum of all these sums that we calculated. After we go through all the possible windows, the minimum sum is subtracted from the total sum, giving us the maximum we are looking for. The solution is right. It works on all arrays and has the correct mindset into it. However, it takes a lot of time to execute because of the nested loops and is not optimal in terms of implementation. To fix it, we can notice one particular property in the subarray sum we are fetching. You see, in the implementation, we are traversing the whole subarray again and again to recalculate the local sums to find the minimum subarray. However, what we can do instead is keep track of the very first sum we have, and as we progress in the iteration, we update this same variable by subtracting the element we removed from the window and by adding the new element. To implement this, we can start by traversing the very first window separately and retrieve the sum of its elements. Then, as we go over the remaining windows, we update the local subarray sums while keeping track of the minimum between these sums we calculated. The local minimums are stored in an array, and to calculate a certain minimum, we are making use of the previous minimum calculated and then add to it the upcoming integer and subtract the very first element of that window. One first minor optimization we can do at this point is integrate the total sum we are calculating into the loop we already have instead of fetching it separately, since inside this loop we are in fact traversing the elements of the array. Another optimization would be to basically get rid of the array storing the local sums of the windows and replace it with one single variable, since all we need is the previous sum calculated when attempting to retrieve a new one. And that's it. The link to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.